Hey family, I hope you guys are doing well and that you had a great holiday and that you're still enjoying it for those of you who are off today. But I just wanted to come on and share this word that the Lord spoke to my spirit maybe sometime last week. And what he said is, do it my way and you will not fail. You will not fail if you do it God's way. He's very serious about this, and a lot of you are stepping out into this new thing, and as you step out onto the water of this new thing, out of the boat of safety and out of the boat of what you think is comfortable, to get into that uncomfortable zone. So God is proud of you for that. He's rooting you on for that. But as you step out on the water, some of you are starting to sink because you're taking your eyes off of him, right? Because you don't see how it's going to come to pass. So you think you got to start messing with it yourself, you know, and doing what the natural mind will tell you to do to stay afloat, right? But this is a kingdom thing that God has you doing. He wants you to build it his way, right? And so what he is saying is that if you just trust me, if you just do it my way, then you will not fail. And a lot of you, he's taking you through this and he's giving you this wonderful promise of this new thing, whether it's a business, whether it's on your new job, whether it's a ministry that you have started for God. He's saying that in this hour, I have given you this lofty thing because not only am I going to bless you in it, but I'm going to show you how to trust me in this area of your finances, of your faith, okay? Of your confidence in me, right? And so a lot of you have to still put in that time, and we all do. But, you know, specifically in this building phase, press in more to the Lord, and so that you can get his word in your spirit and his promises in your spirit. And that will build up your confidence to step out and do the things that God is asking you to do when you don't see it in the natural, okay? And so God is saying that the provision is here, the manna is here, and some of you are complaining about the manna. Okay, just like the Israelites, like, why are we getting this same thing, or why is it not enough? God is saying, follow the way I am telling you to do it. The overflow is coming. You're going to walk right into it, okay? And so whatever it is that you're building, he also wants you to know that if he did not tell you to partner with anyone, do not partner with anyone. You do not have to ride anybody's coattail to get to where God wants to take you. This is how people start building Ishmael, okay? Isaac is the promise. God wants you to do it his way, okay? So unless he has told you different, do not partner with anyone. And you will feel that in your spirit if you are sensitive and tuned in to the Holy Spirit. You will know that even when those doors of opportunity come and it seems like good ideas, like, yeah, that might be good to partner with someone and, you know, maybe, you know, to make it bigger or make it happen faster or whatever it is. And God is saying you don't need to do that if he has not instructed you to do it. Okay. And I've talked about that before. And I'll link the video, opportunity knocking. Sometimes it's going to be an opportunist knocking who wants to partner with you for their own gain. So you have to be careful in this hour. Okay. And so again, God wants you to build it the way he said build it, because if you do it his way, you will not fail. No matter what, no matter if you're building something that's already been done, it's not going to be done in your case because it's not another you. Okay. God is giving you your own blueprint. This is just like having a subdivision of homes. Okay. And you go in and you go get your house built and you pick out the materials and the elevation, how the front of it will look. You know, there's different options, right? So it is with you. Just because your house is in the same subdivision or your new thing is in the same sphere of someone else's new thing doesn't mean that the materials are going to be the same. It doesn't mean that, you know, the elevation of the way it looks is going to be the same. Okay. It doesn't mean that the elevation, thank you, Holy Spirit, is going to be the same either. Come on, Holy Spirit. All right. So, oh my God, some of you who are looking at others who are in the game of whatever it is you're doing, if we can say that, you know, loosely in the game, doing what you're doing, don't look at where they are. Again, you don't know who's building Ishmael or Isaac. You don't know who's building what you're building. Or what looks, you know, in the same sphere. You don't know if they're building it because they want to build it. Or you don't know if they're building it because God is telling them to build it. This is why you cannot look at anyone else. This is why you have to have tunnel vision on the vision. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Your elevation is specific to you. Okay? How God is blessing one, he's not going to particularly bless you that way, okay? Miracles, the miracles that Jesus did in the scriptures, when he healed people of the same ailments sometimes, he did it different ways, okay? With the blind man, you know, with the mud on his eyes, and he healed another one a different way, but the same healing, come on. So you can't look at it to be done the same way, okay? Hallelujah. My God. So yes, get the training that you need. You know, do your studying. If he said go back to school, do that, okay? Yeah, it's okay to look at, you know, your person that you may follow or look up to or things like that to see and broaden your exposure. But when it comes down to it, after you gather your information, take that to the Lord and say, okay, God, how do you want me to do this? All right? So what I'm saying is you don't have to copy anyone, and you don't have to ride anyone's coattail. God has equipped each and every one of us with everything we need within us, okay? And our life experiences are our witnesses, right? So this is what you are equipped with, your life experience. All right, so you're going to use the things and the different calls that God has called you to throughout your life, in your life, whatever's happened personally to you, and then what you've done, you know, in work or business, all of that clusters together. All those different calls lead up to your final election, which is your destiny, okay? So use that. All of that that's in you, use it. Okay, because that's what God is having you do right now in creating this new thing. He's bringing all that stuff together. Whatever you're doing, you know, ministry, coaching, mentoring, in your business, you're starting a business of some sort. You know, whether it's just office work or anything, okay? It's so many things out here to do. If you're in the industry of music or whatever it is, God has your specific gift and niche within you, okay? So all you have to do is be yourself and seek the Lord to have him show you what that is so that that can come out of you. And don't worry about the naysayers. Don't worry about who doesn't believe in your call or who doesn't think you're qualified. God does the qualifying, okay? Hallelujah. So don't worry about that. You just keep going forward. Keep moving forward. There are many persecutions with those who are called and those who are chosen to do it, those who choose, okay? And you have chosen the path. You want to do what God says do. So therefore, he's saying, build it my way. If you do it the way I tell you to do it, you will not fail. If you build it how I say build it, you will not fail. In the mighty name of Jesus, you guys be encouraged. I love you all. Most importantly, Jesus loves you. And I'll talk to you soon.